Christy Peterson Schoonover's fiction has appeared in many magazines and anthologies. She holds an MFA in creative writing from Goddard College, serves as a co-host of the Dark Discussions podcast, and is a founding editor of the dark literary journal 34 Orchard. Follow her adventures at ChristyPetersonSchoonover.com. Christy, take it away.
Thank you, everybody. I'm glad to be here. I'm going to read the first little bit of the short story called Attempted Delivery, which is from my collection, The Shadows Behind, which is about the monsters that live within us. If you like what you hear, I am going to be giving away one free copy and to the winner, or you can find it on Amazon. Attempted Delivery. A whisper comes from the package intended from my neighbor. I'm Margolin Jameson, and I live at 53 Morgan Avenue, Mystic, Connecticut. The neighbor, Marilyn Jensen, is at 53 Morgan Avenue Extension. Occasionally, that's where my Amazon pantry boxes get delivered. My phone often notifies me that my item has been left on the porch. I don't have a porch, so I cut through the woods, descend the embankment, and navigate the rickety wooden steps that parallel her steep driveway to get the parcel. Marilyn and I haven't met. She's never home, no matter what time of day or night it is. My girlfriend, Suzanne, who met her once, claims Marilyn works for a museum and that she's probably always traveling to exotic places. Suzanne, though, has a talent for romanticizing. I didn't take her seriously until the first time I stood on Marilyn's porch amidst tiki statues, wind chimes made of bones, and shrunken heads. It's creepy, and I'm an anxious person. It's only my need for eyeliner and tampons that keeps me going back. But this is the first time one of her deliveries has ended up at my place, and it's only right to go drop it off. I'm about to pick up the box when I hear the whisper, "Broken lobster." What the hell was that? I look to see if anyone's around. There isn't. "Broken lobster." What does that mean, anyway? I'm supposed to take Suzanne to Red Lobster for her birthday, and that's been on my mind because it's her favorite place, and I'm not really a fan of seafood. That's probably it. "Broken lobster." There it is again. I'm afraid to touch the box. It didn't come from Amazon. In fact, the return and shipping addresses are the same. Marilyn Jensen, 53 Morgan Avenue Extension. Someone was desperate to make sure this got to the right place. Then I think, she won't be home, and what if the thing inside is alive? It shouldn't be left outside in the cold. It's the first week in April, but the nights are still dipping down below freezing on occasion, and the pouring rains we've had for the past 2 days don't make anything more hospitable. What if what's in there dies of exposure? What if it's broken lobster, it whispers. I lift the box. It's light. When I shake it, something rattles, but it feels like it's in one piece. Maybe it's another one of those weird bone things that are hanging all around Marilyn's porch. I put my ear to the box. This time, even louder. "Broken lobster!" Startled, I drop it on the ceramic tile of my foyer floor. Crap, 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 crap. What if it's broken? "Open it," I tell myself. "Just check it out. Make sure it's intact, whatever it is." The problem is it's wrapped completely in what looks like butcher shop paper. If I tear into it, there's no way I'll be able to hide the evidence that it's been opened. "Broken lobster!" it screams. That's it. I have to do it. I get a knife. One of the joys of living alone, no one yells at you for using one of the good steak knives to open your mail. And plan my strategy. Every seam and flap is plastered in tape. It's a struggle not only to get the knife in, but also to keep from stabbing myself. At last, I'm through. The knife, now covered in sticky residue, is probably ruined. I toss it in the sink where it lands on a precariously stacked pile of the Pier 1 dishes my last girlfriend left here. I sincerely hope I broke at least one of them. I work the box free of the paper and pull off the lid, inhaling a waft of something that smells like rotting leaves and bourbon. Once it passes, I take a peek. Inside is an intact, petrified fish. What kind, I have no idea, but the protruding mouth armed with murderous teeth gives me chills. Its taut, grayish tobacco skin, only slightly hardier than tissue and tackier than crepe paper, is worn in patches, revealing its bones. Equally disturbing are dark brush strokes marbling its rib cage, meticulously painted characters in a maroon ink that bleeds into hairline cracks in the bones, spreading like tree roots. But it's the perfectly round, tenantless eye sockets that nail stalactites through my core. They look angry. Okay, I'll stop there. Thank you.